So when during a tennis career are tennis lessons most helpful or most valuable? That's what we're going to be talking about today in this video. My name is Ian. I'm the head pro here at EssentialTennis.com, and welcome to this episode of Ask Ian. Today I'm going to be answering a question from Randy, who wrote on, I think, YouTube and said, this was in response to a previous Ask Ian episode where I talked about how far a player can make it as far as level is concerned without getting professional coaching. So he replied and said, you answered clearly, but for some people it may be helpful to quantify the journey, even just with approximations. Is going from 4.0 to 4.5 easier than going from 4.5 to 5.0? If so, then there's a premium on getting excellent coaching the higher you go up the exponential skill curve. Okay, Randy, I see what you're saying, but I would say definitely not necessarily the way that you said. Yes, there's no question that the better you become, the more the growth curve flattens out. In other words, you can fully expect at first to make improvements very, very quickly and then start to slowly level out. And maybe you'll have some big breakthrough and make a big jump. But after a certain amount of improvement, unless you're just an exceptional athlete, there will be a flattening out of your improvement. And there will come a period where it's very incremental and improvements come one at a time. And sometimes you have to work on those incremental improvements for weeks or even months. And that's when it becomes really, really important to just enjoy the learning process. I'm starting to talk about something else. Going back to Randy's question, I would say that generally speaking, when it's most important to get high quality instruction would be as early as humanly possible in your tennis career. If you're just beginning, then invest in some really fundamentally sound, strong instruction immediately. Because for me as a teacher, as a coach, when I work with students, I can tell you that the vast majority of our time, identification is very, very quick and easy for me. Within 10, 20 reps of any given stroke, I know what we're gonna work on. I know what the process is. I know what the path is. The hard part or the slow part, the part that takes time is the rewriting of the habits of the student. So when students come to me, they've had years, sometimes decades, of repetitions doing things a certain way. And maybe they've advanced during that period of time, but they have a general set of habits or ways that they like to move their body. And that may or may not be a good thing. Usually it's not a good thing. We pick out things that need to be improved. And most of our time is spent trying to help that person get from where they are now to where they need to be. And that means overriding, rewriting their previous habits. So if you can begin your tennis journey with some really fundamentally sound instruction to give you some solid base movement patterns in each of your strokes, if you could invest a little bit on the front end and then go by yourself and work on that, especially if that instructor gives you some kind of process to follow, gives you some kind of roadmap and really lays out what you should be trying to achieve, what kind of your end goal is, and then sends you on your way, that would be best to start off with first. Now, that being said, every player is gonna come to a big plateau at different levels. And so I can't say, well, at 4.0, then you wanna go invest in some coaching again and then wait until you're 5.0, and then again, you wanna go back and get some coaching. It's totally different for each player depending on how much of a natural athlete they are, which generally speaking means how much prior experience they have in other sports. How much have they trained their body already for coordination? How much self-awareness do they have with how they're moving their body? If the answer to that is it's a very high level, then they may be able to go on their way for quite a while before they need some more guidance. But my general answer to your question, Randy, is invest as early as possible in really high quality coaching and then periodically check in with a high quality coach to make sure that you are staying on the right path and you're not deviating in one way or another. Hopefully that's helpful. If you're looking to hit the most accurate and consistent ground strokes of your life, I'm gonna put a link in the description down below to some coaching that'll just cost you $1. Make sure to check that out. If you'd like some high quality coaching that can guide you down a path to improvement and a long-term process, a long-term path, not just quick band-aid fixes here and there. So go check out that link down below. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any comments or questions in the section down below. Give us a like if you enjoyed this video, and be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and basically every other social network so that you don't miss out on the content that we're constantly publishing. Thanks for watching. Take care, and good luck with your tennis. For hundreds of free digital tennis lessons, head over to EssentialTennis.com right now. More wins and more fun on the court is right around the corner. You'll even get a free gift just for stopping by. Simply click the link at the top of any page.